Okay, I believe we are recording now. Hi, everybody. I want to introduce you to Anna. Anna is a certified STTP clinician, and she has agreed to talk to you today about the process and her experience as a certified stone tongue thrust protocol user. We are doing this a little differently than I've ever done it before, and it's on purpose because I want you to experience a little bit of what the online experience looks like for the certification program. So unlike the other courses in the STTP Training Center, the other courses are pretty one-sided. So I lecture and you participate just like any traditional online education experience. But with the certification program, it's a lot more interactive, and we finish the course with an exam, a competency exam, and we do it through this medium, which is Zoom. And so all I'm doing today is recording a conversation between Anna and I that is very similar to what you would see or what you would experience during the STTP competency exam. So I've just hit record, and we're going to talk to Anna a little bit about her experience and what it was like and what she felt was helpful. First of all, maybe we need to get to know a little bit about you, Anna. And would you just tell us real quick, you have a private practice, right?
Yes, I do.
In Emmett, Idaho. No shameless plug there. We want to have lots of work for Anna. And she was just telling me off camera that her clinic is expanding. And because she's such a successful business owner, she hasn't had a ton of time to grow her tongue thrust niche because she has a lot of preschool kiddos coming in. So those of you who are speech therapists out there, you know that that is often a very high demand population that we have, early intervention. And so Anna's no exception. This is a small portion of what she does, but she felt like it was beneficial enough to become certified in the protocol. And so that's what I want to talk to her about today. And you said, do you also, you contract a little bit?
With Head Start. Okay. Birth to five is the age range there that I work with.
Okay. And then in your clinic, you see all ages, or do you cap at 18 or?
All ages.
All ages. Okay. And the lion's share of your population is probably birth to five then?
Yeah, pretty much.
Across the board. Okay. But you have a robust after school population, it sounds like, too.
Ew.
All right. So I guess let's just start out with maybe if you could share your experience with the online advanced certification process and this kind of what you felt like you gained from it, what it was like.
Okay. I really like the online process because I'm a mom and I have kiddos at home, and it gave me the flexibility to complete the course. I did it over the summer break between school. And so I had a lot of time to watch the videos and read the book and go through all of that with my family's schedule. It was really nice. I also was working a little bit in the private practice. During the summer, I had a caseload of maybe 10 kiddos, and one of them, I was realizing as I was going through the course, had a tongue thrust. And so I was able to work with him while I was going through the course, which was really beneficial because the videos on the course were amazing. I thought that I got a really good understanding from the videos from the course, but then being able to come into the clinic and see the kid right in front of me was really, really beneficial for me as well. So it worked out. It's pretty ideal, I would say, for my experience.
That's fantastic. So you felt like the, you know, when I first took the course from in-person to online, one of my concerns was maintaining the integrity of the course and the making sure that the students were really getting that education so that they really could competently assess and diagnose and treat mm-hmm. same level of efficiency that we were getting with a hands-on workshop. So do you feel like you were able to accomplish that in the, you know, even though it wasn't just a quick workshop certification, it was over a longer period of time and it was kind of asynchronous. Do you feel like that was still beneficial for you?
Yes, absolutely. I think being able to go back and rewatch some of the videos was really beneficial. Having the book with me was really beneficial. And also the oral mech sheet that you give was really beneficial. And having you as a resource, I mean, I emailed you quite a few different times, and I did while I was working with that client asking different questions, and you were a great resource too. And you were always really good about getting back to me very promptly and helping.
Thank you. That's great, because that was one of my big fears, and actually a benefit that I didn't really anticipate, but I've heard that from quite a few students who've said they loved that they could go back. And I realized that when you're doing a live workshop, if you miss it, you don't really realize it, or, you know, you're trying to take notes as fast and furiously as possible. But I think that that's actually a benefit of the online that we don't get in real time, is that you're able to digest it, apply it. If you have a kiddo in your actual services, you can be like, oh man, what did Callie say? And you can go back and you can look at it. Or you can always call me, right? So we can figure it out that way. And I do offer that as a part of the advanced certification. If you're going to be certified, I want to make sure that you really do know what you're doing, and that if you have any questions, you're always welcome. I will be here. As long as I'm a practicing breathing clinician, I will stand behind that guarantee that I will do my best to co-treat or to problem solve or to do whatever. So that is definitely a part of that process. Now, once that you are certified, how do you feel like it's benefited your skill set, your practice? What's the benefit of, you know, making that investment? That was a big investment in time and money to be able to get that certification. Do you feel like it was worth it? And if so, how?
Yes, definitely. I feel like it gave me a much greater understanding of when I was doing the oral mech and looking at the child's mouth and really determining what was going on, because I was never really confident in that area. And so now when I have a kid sit down in front of me, I'm looking at them with a different perspective and trying to figure out what exactly is going on. Especially I think I used to look at lisping as just an articulation error. And if I couldn't fix it, maybe I was using the wrong strategy or I needed to use different prompting. And now I have different perspective and I can think, well, do they have a tongue thrust? Is there something else going on here? And a lot of times that is the issue. And so I'm able to just look at them differently and have more information to actually give a correct diagnosis and a more appropriate treatment plan, which has really helped.
So even if it hasn't been a child who's been appropriate to use the entire protocol, your skill set and just the way you assess in general has benefited.
Definitely. And when I do have those 3 to 5 year olds, if I can tell that they are tongue thrusters, I know they're on my radar. So as soon as they get to an appropriate age or maturity level where I feel like, okay, we can go for it, then they're set up and they're ready and we can go down that avenue.
Fantastic. That's awesome. So what would you say to a clinician such as yourself? We know that continuing education is something that we don't all have a lot of time or a lot of money for. And so we take it very seriously and want to make sure that it's appropriate for us. You know, so if I am a clinician who's thinking, what is the STTP? Never heard of it. And why would I do it? What would your advice be to that professional?
Well, I just feel like being as an SLP, we have such a big scope of practice. And I think having this in my toolbox has really helped me just to be prepared for whatever walks in the door, because I think we just need lots of tools. And being able to look through this perspective and determine if they are a tongue thruster, it just really changes. It changed the way that I looked at kids when I was evaluating them, and what, like, it gave me an additional thing to look for, I guess, to either determine, yes, it was there or no, it's not. And that has just really helped me.
Awesome. Well, thank you. I appreciate your time. I appreciate your support. And I am just thrilled and so proud of you and your practice. And to call you a certified practitioner is a thrill that I have. So thank you, Anna, for taking the time.
Yes, thank you.
All right.